next thing we're after. At this time, I need you to pull the stock out.
This step here is pretty important because you got a whole bunch of loose stuff once you release this upper housing. But once you got your three screws out, this whole housing is going to come apart. One thing you got to watch is there's a cam in here, inside here, for your dimmer switch. And that'll all come loose. So you pull the housing out like this. Hold that, lay it down like that. Here's your cam I'm talking about. This is your dimmer switch right here. Pay attention to how that is. It lays right in that housing. I use wheel bearing grease on this. I put wheel bearing grease on there. It's sticky. It sticks right on there. It won't come off. So when you put it back together, you can engage it into the dimmer switch rod.
Is there anything in this you can't clean with like carb or contact cleaner?
I wouldn't clean this plastic stuff. That would
just wipe.
Probably put, you have an automatic column extension, probably could you put it in there?
Yeah, you could.
They don't have the safety control.
So in terms of frequency of failure, what would be kind of the most frequent?
I can't predict that. I've seen 30,000 mile cars that had this problem. I've seen 200,000 mile cars that are as tight as a bone.
I meant not just that, but I mean you talked about, you know, this and which component.
The most common component that have problems is the grid stuff.
It is the stick.
That's the absolutely the most component.
They get broken.
Yeah, they kick them with their knee, or they wear it out. These wires are very, very brittle. It's solid wire. It's not stranded wire at all. They're so small. You can see them here. They're only like 28 gauge, are really deep in the lines. And to break them, it's real easy. Usually they're broke off right here. And people bust them